And welcome back. In this tutorial, we are going to make Pseudo Rings animation in Microsoft PowerPoint. Pseudo meaning, it's not really what it looks like. The animation is a replica of S. Sharirar's works at codepen.io. This tutorial will help you to understand how the spin effect and motion path behave in PowerPoint and how you can use them efficiently. I will also recommend you watch two of our previous tutorials about how to use motion paths in PowerPoint, in which we illustrated another example to use paths efficiently and how and when to use locked, unlocked origin for motion paths. The links to these videos are given in the description and in the cards. Now, let's talk about this pseudo rings animation, and first, we will talk about how these rings have been designed and placed in the presentation by opening the selection pane from the Home tab. We have placed three rings on top of each other, and each ring is a group of 11 oval shapes. Each dot that you see inside the ring is at 36 degrees from another. Then we grouped all the 10 oval shapes with one large oval, which is made hidden using no outline. If you right-click on any of these ovals and choose Format Shape and then go to Shape Effects, then under Glow Options you can see that we have applied a glow size of 8 points with a transparency of 60%. Let's open the animation pane from the Animations tab, and here you can see that we have applied the circle motion path on all the three rings, which you can find under Add Animation, More Motion Paths, and then choose Circle. If we zoom in over the motion paths, then you can see that each path is at the same place, but only the starting point of the motion path has been changed using the rotation. If you start selecting these motion paths one by one from the animation pane, then you can notice the exact starting position of each of the paths. If you hold the rotation point and start rotating manually, then you can see the movement of each of the rings, and that is what it all takes to create this pseudo rings animation in PowerPoint. The accuracy of the animation totally depends on the start point of each motion path that we applied to each ring. You cannot apply the spin effect to these rings as it will create a different effect. On the second slide, we showcase the outline of all the three ovals, and if you stare at the ovals alone, then it seems that each oval is rotating around another, but if you stare over a ring, then you see a different effect. On the third slide, we just increase the duration of the effects so you may clearly see how each ring is moving around another. The fourth slide has completely a different design of the rings, and we use the spin effect instead of motion paths. Here, if we look into the selection pane, then you can notice that all the 10 oval groups have been grouped differently than the preceding slides. If I show you only of the group, then you can see that three ovals, red, yellow, and blue, have been grouped inside a large oval, and then again, all those four ovals again have been grouped with another large oval. A total of 5 oval shapes has been used in one group. We then replicated and placed the same group 10 times each at 36 degrees from another. We only need to show red, yellow, and blue ovals, so we made the other two ovals hidden through the selection pane. If I turn on all the layers and see the slideshow, then you can notice a different output. If we hide the bigger ovals through selection pane, then you will notice a different output. So that is how the motion path and spin effects behave differently over the grouped shapes. I hope you got the teacher point and will find this tutorial useful. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications, so you may not miss the next tutorial. Thanks a lot for watching and have a wonderful day.